Let's go to calls. Christine in St. Louis, Missouri, listening on KHOJ Covenant Network. You are on with Sarah Swafford.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you.
Sarah, I wanted to ask you a question to get input as a parent. I have a son that's in Catholic grade school. He's in fourth grade. And I went to a mom's night out a couple weeks ago, and I found out that, now my son doesn't do this, but a lot of the other kids in the class, they have cell phones, and they are texting one another, like, out of school hours and things like that. And it's not just in the fourth grade, it's in the upper grades, too, because I talked to some teachers about this. And that the kids text each other all the time, and a lot of times it's not nice things that they say about one another. And these are small classes. It's just, you know, like 20 kids per class, per grade.
Mm-hmm.
And there's all this stuff going on, and the tone that I got from the parents and the teacher was that it's like nobody knows, none of the adults know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
Except if something is really wrong, then they'll say, you know, that's inappropriate, you know, don't do this again, or I'm going to, you know, call your parent.
Yeah, that was a great question. And to be honest, I've been doing my ministry for about seven, 8 years, and I have just seen the age of people getting phones just get lower and lower. At first, it was very much like a high school thing. It was very much a junior high thing. And now we're definitely seeing the average age of a student getting their phone, or a child getting their phone, is really becoming about 8 or 9, you know, which is 8, 9, 10. And so I want to clarify this with Christine and everyone out there listening. You know, I don't for a minute pretend to be an expert on this, because my kids are 11, 9, 5, and almost 2. So I always just kind of come at this as, man, if you have a teenager out there, or if you have a young, you know, an elementary school student, or even a junior high student, like, I would love to sit at your feet for 3 hours and listen to what you have to say about it, because I'm on the brink of all of this as well. And so, but I also have the ear of high school and college students and young adults. And one of my favorite things to ask them is, so what did your parents do right? And what do you wish they would have done differently? And that's just really good for me, because they just came out of this and they're able to kind of reflect on it and say, okay, this is what I wish we would have had. And this is what, you know. And one of the things that I have been seeing that has been so interesting is to have young adults come to me and talk about their phone. And a lot of them talk about their addiction to their phone, where, you know, like, addiction meaning I can't imagine my life without it and I'm on it all the time. And one of the things that I've been seeing is a lot of them are talking about the fact that there's no accountability. There's no accountability when they're in their room with their phone alone. So whether you're talking about, you know, it's very hard, I think, for, you know, to hand a phone to like an 11 or 12 or 13 year old boy with like full data capabilities. He can jump online on the internet. He can talk to anybody he wants to anywhere in the world, or he can text the people in his classes, you know, like, that's just a lot of, to be totally honest, that's a lot of responsibility that child has on his shoulders to make the right decision. And to always, you know, it's just so easy. The devil knows exactly how to mess with us. And, you know, it's so easy. So when you start talking about high schoolers, or you start talking about junior high students, or in Christine's case, you know, fourth grade, what I'm seeing a lot of is, unfortunately, bullying. It's a lot that younger, you know, elementary, junior high, what they do is it's really become kind of a cyber thing, you know, a cyber bullying thing. Like she said, you know, they're not always saying the nicest things about people or about each other. We talked a little earlier about conflict resolution. You know, like, if you're upset with someone, you know, back 50 years ago, you approached them and you talked about it, or, you know, at the, you know, whatever, however that went down. But now you can just send a nasty text message to 18 other people, or you can post something online. And, or if you want to hurt someone's reputation in high school, you can make up things, you can say things, you can post videos of something that happened that was, maybe not something someone else wanted to see or have out there about themselves. You know, it's just so multifaceted. And so, you know, I think talking to Christine, you know, as a mother as well with boys the same age, I think that the question I think we have to ask is, how do we help them grow in virtue, whether they have a phone or not? And especially with, you know, I think a lot of parents want their kids to have phones so that they can, you know, hey, it's after soccer practice, I need picked up. You know, like, hey, it's, you know, I need to go, I'm at school, things got out early, can you come get me? It's a lot easier to text them. It's, you know, high school, junior high, elementary, it's easier to send a text message. And I totally get that. I think the question we have to just ask ourselves is, you know, how do we set them up to succeed, right? So if I need to get a hold of you, I mean, is there ways I can get a hold of you without you having to have a phone full of data where you can jump on and look at things? You know, some parents, you know, have talked a lot about their, you know, their kids have a phone, but their phone is very much like kind of one that you would see at the AT&T store at the very end of the counter that just flips up and only has numbers, and it doesn't have, you know, any capabilities to do any internet, or it might even not have texting, but your son or daughter can pick up the phone and call you and say, hi, like, come get me, you know? So it's just a lot, you know. The other thing I love, and I hope this helps, this really helped me, especially during Lent. A lot of people have asked, how do I hold myself accountable to the time I spend on my phone at any age? But this mom approached me one time after a talk, and her advice was genius. She had kids that were all ages, and she actually built what she called the nest. And it was this little, like, honest to God, it was a little, like, cage, like a little bird cage that she had right by the garage door in her kitchen. And she had a power strip, and it had all of the phone cords charging. And basically, when you walked through the door, you plugged your phone into the nest. You put it to bed in the nest. And she basically said there was no rules. It wasn't like you couldn't use your phone. Basically, what it was is you plugged your phone in, and you're at home. It's family time. You don't get to take your phone to your bedroom with you. You don't get to take your phone throughout the house, because when it's plugged in the nest, she could see, yeah, if you want to take a call or if you want to call your friend, totally, go call them. Or if you want to answer a text message, go ahead. That's fine. But she could see in her kitchen how long you were standing there, who you were talking to, what was going on. There was accountability there, right? She knew what you were up to. And what she said was it really helped her, because, you know, another dad I talked to said he had 8 kids. The first 4 went through with the phone on the wall in the kitchen, and the other 4 went through with cell phones. And he said, you know, that with those first 4, he's like, I knew when they, you know, when they, especially when they were like high school, you know, I knew what was going on. I knew who was talking to who. I knew who was interested in who. I knew who was dating who. I knew how it was going. I knew when they broke up. I knew, you know, I knew everything without having to be on the phone, but there was accountability there. And I knew how long you've been on the phone. I knew everything, right? And he said when the next 4, his next set went through with cell phones, he's like, I didn't know who was talking to who. I didn't know who was dating who. I didn't know what, I knew when they broke up, but I just saw like the effects of it. I didn't know what happened. So I really learned a lot from that dad, you know, and just like what's kind of the changing and how we approach this. And I think just anything that you can do to help bring about conversation about how much is good for you. I have another mom that sets a timer. She has a little egg timer, and she sets it for 30 minutes at night, and everyone gets 30 minutes on their phone to do their social media, to do their texting, to do their thing. And then the phones go back into the nest. And, you know, that's just their way of being more available to their family and being more of, you know. So to Christine's question on what do you do with everybody else has a phone and everyone else is doing it, I think you just really have to evaluate for your own family just what level of participation do you want to have in that? And then also what's healthy for your age group child of either how much or what is the phone able to do, the capabilities, so that there's some accountability there at any age. You know, I know a lot of parents who have told me they set timers on their phone because they feel like they are on it too much and they want to spend more time with their kids, you know, and so it's fabulous. It's also, you know, things like Covenant Eyes. I just want to throw out to my friend Matt Frad, and you know, there's some amazing work that Chassis Project, who I work for, we're trying to do with pornography, and just really trying to call out, you know, call a spade and just really say, like, this is, you know, this is affecting everyone, men, women, children, young adults. It is just so in your face, and it's so everywhere on social media and on your phone. Even checking the news is like scary sometimes, you know? So I just think we really need to, you know, to hold each other accountable and to really be honest with each other about what's going on in our teens' lives and our young adults' lives and our kids' lives. But we need to look in the mirror and look at our own lives too and really see like how much and what is affecting me and how is it affecting my worth as a person. You know, just all those things. I know that's a long answer, but that's probably my best shot at it.
So. Well, thank you, Christine, for that question.